Rock and roll day of May was the Georgia Jam. If you weren't there, the Naked Truth was. Check it out. Southgang and more on this week's edition of The Naked Truth.
Howdy, rockers. This is Steve Brown.
PJ Farley from Trickster, and you're watching
The Naked. Oh, my God.
He's Naked Truth.
The Naked Truth. Turn it up. See.
Hello, this is Jay Spencer,
Butch Walker,
Jesse Hart,
and Mitch McLean,
and we're
Southgang,
the southern boys that make the noise.
And you're getting the Atlanta music scene uncovered on The Naked Truth, so stick around.
All right.
See ya.
Hey, Baron, this is The Naked Truth. We're backstage here at Lakewood Amphitheater. We have the South Gang guys just coming into town here to rock out the Georgia Jam. Any thoughts? Hey.
All right.
Hey, these guys are like, hey, get them on stage now, all right? Hey, we got Jesse here. We got Butch. We got Jace. And we got Mitch here, South Gang. They're from Rome.
Southern boys to make the noise.
Hey, I just came down from Rome tonight, got some home cooking last night. So these guys are ready to rock the folks out here at Lakewood Amphitheater. It's the 96 Rock Georgia Jam. Before we get into getting in-depth with these guys, let's go ahead and get Dave Siff and the music news update. Hey, and we're back. We've got South Gang guys here. Jesse, tell me about what the show's going to be about today.
Well, we're just going to go out and do a quick 30-minute set and go out and just nonstop rocking, no ballads. We're just going to go out there and throw it in their face for 30 minutes. So just we're going to be doing like 6 songs off the album. Cool. And just our fastest, most hard rocking stuff.
All right, man.
It's going to be a good show, I hope.
It's going to be a shock.
Awesome. Throw them in shock.
Hey, tell me what it's like to be playing back in Atlanta for the first time in, what, 2-3 years?
Oh, yeah. Actually, we haven't played as South Gang in Atlanta ever. This is our first time. We were a Bite the Bullet about 2 years ago here, and we were just playing the clubs in Atlanta, so this is going to be a first. I mean, I think people are in for a real surprise, too, because we've come a long way since then as far as our playing and our songs and everything in our show, and I think it's going to show. We're really looking forward to it.
So. All right, man. South Gang, if you can't tell, look at these faces here. Can we get a look at all these faces? Let's just do a panning shot. These guys are pretty young, you know what I'm saying? Ooh. Hey.
Just a young.
You guys, we have...
But a wee bitty.
So, we have this little piece we produced on another band. It's called Trickster. You guys have heard Trickster.
Great band.
We came down here to Lakewood recently when they jammed with the Scorpions, and we talked to PJ and Steve, and roll tape.
Hey, the PJ Dana
show here. Hey, we're back with South Gang. Jace here has had a little bit too much caffeine, maybe.
The Tylenol is what did it. Thanks, Joe.
Really? The road life's been has it been hard on the guys, or how's it been?
I don't know, man. No, we're veterans at this.
Really?
'Tis but flesh wounds for us all.
Really? Okay. So, like, where'd you guys come from? Like, on the road, some big shows in the past?
What? Yeah, we just did our first outdoor arena, which was, what was it, Compadre Stadium. For Milwaukee Brewers, which, and we'll let them pass, we're Braves fans, but we did that 10,000 people, and
who'd you play with?
Great White, Bang Tango, Eyes,
Tough. And, that's a new band that I heard Poison's like working with, Brett Michaels.
Yeah, cool, man.
So,
I didn't know that, that's cool.
Tell me about the recording that you guys did with the, Desmond Childs, like, how was that like?
He was really great working with. I mean, we really learned a lot in our writing and all the songs. I mean, he just kind of like added all the spice to our songs. We knew all the, you know, we brought in the songs to him, and he just kind of like added the spice to it and made it a hit.
Really? Yeah. Hey, what's it like being on stage with a guy like Jesse with the pipes that he's got? I mean, it's like...
He's a nut!
Jesse, this is the man right here with the pipes.
The
lead singer from South Gang, Jesse. So like when you're on stage, like... How much eye contact do you make with the women?
Oh, as much as possible. You know.
I had to pick his eyes up a couple of times off the floor.
They keep rolling out of my head, and I have to chase them
all over on my guitar.
If his pants went to the back, come out his pants leg.
Delete. Okay, let's get to some more serious things. Okay, we're getting ready to play a video, the first one off Tainted Angels. So, like, let's talk about some of the production things that you guys put into this video? Tell us a little bit how long it took.
It was like a 2-day project, and we went in and just rocked hard. I mean, there was not a lot of direction, really. I mean, they set the cameras up and said, roll, and we just went in there and rocked. I mean, great director, Marty Colliner. He shot all the Poison videos and most of the Aerosmith videos, and his insight was really, I mean, really helped us through it.
Cool, man. Yeah. So, like, where'd you guys shoot it at?
We shot it in A&M Studios in Hollywood.
Really? Do you feel like you guys, this is it, man, we made the big time? What are your thoughts
on
that?
No. There's too much more to do. I mean, you know, if you get out, we played for, you know, 10,000 people, close to 10,000 people the other day for the first time ever, and that was like a big rush, but it's like, that's not good enough. We need 20,000 now. I mean, it's just like we want album sales, you know. We want gold, but if we go gold, we want platinum. We want platinum. We want double platinum, you know.
You want money.
Well, that's, you know, we're not in it for the money. We're in it for the fun of it. It's a good time doing what we're doing. And success. You can't really define and put a phrase on it, you know,
can't
for success.
It.
Yeah, well, you can't measure it either, unless you got a measuring device. But I mean, for success, you know, there's no way of defining it for you because, you know, I think the only way you're gonna know is when you're sitting back and you're happy and you're stable,
guys are giving
secure.
We want more. We want more. We want more. We want more.
You're making me happy.
Happy. Okay, let's talk to Jace over here. Calm down. It's all right. It's all right.
Hang in there, baby.
Phone home. Phone home.
Man, rent.
We're at home, guys. Well, hey, Jace, you're like the newest member of the band, right? So.
Yeah, dude.
So tell us how'd you get in the band?
Well, okay, I'm a road club veteran dog, whatever, and these guys, we like grew up knowing each other, and. They had written a bunch of songs, and I went home for a break from the club thing, and they gave me a tape, and I went by the rehearsal. I mean, their stuff was strong, their songs were strong, and I said, well, you know, anything, if you ever need me, if Brian, the old bass player, ever leaves, call me, let me know. So, well, they decided to move to L.A., let's go get a record deal. So they moved out to L.A. They got there, and Brian, before they hadn't played out or anything, they were just scoping the scene, checking things out. And Brian decided it wasn't for him, which everybody respects him for that, making the decision. And they gave me a call. They said, hey, you want the gig? I said, I'll be there. You know, but they came home for Christmas, and they kind of saw it coming. And we waited out, and I went out the first of the year, and I think it was 89. And
so you've been with them a while.
Things clicked. We had we had three rehearsals. They had a thing called a No Bozos Jam set up at the Whiskey A Go-Go. And when they did it, they said, well, we got three rehearsals. Can you do it? I said, yeah, no problem. We did it. We went out, and we got the review on Rock City News or something, the local rag. They said, one of the tightest bands seen on the strip, blah, blah, blah. And we're like, whoa, three rehearsals, man. And it was great. The magazine's caught on with a lot of press and a lot of help from some of the local promoters. We were headlining within 4 months and selling out all our shows, and we were real fortunate.
Awesome.
And we were signed off for our live show. We didn't have a demo tape. We worked real hard on our tupo. We worked real hard on the harmonies and the live performance. We're definitely a live band. We're seeing
like
best.
It loud.
We're seeing best at our best live on an arena stage where we have a lot of room to fall
like
down.
Like today.
Make of ourselves.
Cool, man. Well, let me talk to this guy right here. Hey, Mitch.
What's going on?
We're getting ready to play the video. You want to like give us any anecdotes from what the video shoot, because we're getting ready to play it.
Well, this is our first video from our debut album. This is Tainted Angel. Hope you enjoy it, and we'll see ya.
Back, the show's just about over. We got some live footage coming up. We got a story on Stiff Kitty. Let's just talk about the live show here. Mitch, tell me a little bit about it.
Well, we're a really active band. I mean, we're just full of energy.
Hormones are flying.
Hormones are flying. Matter of fact, I'm going to go now.
They're all over the place.
I got to go now.
Hey, get back in here, man.
I'm back.
Oh, my gosh.
You'll see that in a minute.
All right, let's go some live footage here.
This is some wonderful footage from the great Atlanta, Georgia Jam. We hope you enjoy this.
Jam on it.
Get
Void Where Distributed.
Yeah.
Okay, that was some live footage from Lakewood Amphitheater. Southgang, whoa, we got some women around here, guys. They're in cages next door, actually. All for these guys right here. Okay, we got some good information here. You guys have had some success on Headbangers Ball. Tell me about it, Jess.
We did real good this week. They put us up against Taiketto and the Ball Buster, which is the once a week they put two videos up against each other, and the current champion, you know, keeps consecutively going each weekend until someone knocks him out. And it's a 900 number, and people call and vote. You know, it's a 50-cent call, and you call and vote, and then the next weekend you find out the percentages. And we slid through, won 49-51% against Taiketto.
Great, man, great. I'll tell you what, we have a local band here in Atlanta that rocks the club scene.
What's the name?
Stiff Kitty. You ever heard of them? You guys got any cat noises?
What do they mean by that?
Stiff Kitty.
Stiff Kitty.
What is that?
Ooh, I don't know if we can say this on the air. Can anybody sound like a cat?
He does. He does on that.
Give me a howl. Give me a howl. let's try Butch here. That's a dog. Stiff doggy.
How about men who love sheep in heat.
Hey, Stiff Kitty rocks Atlanta. Check him out at a club near you.
Yeah, all right. Rock on, Stiff Kitty.
And another wild episode of The Naked Truth. We have a lot of special things going out. We have Jenny Samos from Charisma. She's in New York. We have Jim Davenport locally here in Atlanta. A lot of thanks to those guys. How about this guy? Billy Morgan. Road manager Jeff Gribble. The man with the shades
all
on right now. People can't see him right now.
Just thank all of our families.
Are we rolling credits?
I want to thank my cat, King.
And let's go some live footage as we roll the credits and say goodbye to everybody out there, guys.
Goodbye,
Vista. We'll see you next time.
Later.
This song is dedicated to you people. Enjoy.